Hello and welcome to the line leader section of Process Industry Chronicle magazine. We feel honored to introduce Mr. Prashant Parmar, who is General Manager Projects Zydus Cadila, which is actually API park based at Baroda, Gujarat. Welcome to Process Industry Chronicle magazine, sir.
Thank you so much.
Sir, I request you to kindly introduce yourself to our readers of Process Industry Chronicle magazine, sir.
My name is Prashant Parmar. I am working in Cadila Healthcare Limited, Zydus Cadila, in API divisions as a project head since 2010. I am basically chemical engineering. I am working in industry from last 22 years.
Sir, what are your current job responsibilities in your current company, sir?
Basically, myself and my team is looking responsible for all the infrastructure and productivity enhancement of API divisions of Cadila.
Sir, please tell us in detail about Cadila Healthcare, the company that you're working in, and its history. Sir.
Well, Cadila Healthcare is a group of company owned by Mr. Pankaj Bhai Patel. He is the chairman of this group, and Mr. Sharvil Patel is the managing director of this organization. We have different business setups, strategic business units are there. One of is API. We have various business setup like formulation department, formulations, veterinary departments, cosmetic divisions, and all such, out of which one is API. It's a very old organization. Founder member was Mr. Raman Bhai Patel and Mr. Inderwar Modi. They have started this factory as a Cadila Laboratories. Then Mr. Inderwar Modi and Mr. Raman Bhai team has bifurcated into two organizations. One has become Zydus Cadila and another has become Cadila Pharmaceuticals in 1994.
Sir, can you tell us about the products and services of your company, sir?
We used to manufacture active pharmaceutical ingredients. We have more than 170 plus molecules here. We have a setup of factories at Ankleshwar, Baroda, and Ahmedabad.
Sir, what are your strengths and what are your weaknesses as a person, sir?
Strength, I am working in from last 22 years I am working in chemical industries. I have started my career as a production guy, then I have switched over to process department, and finally I stepped my foot in project engineering. From last 15 years I am working as a project person and looking after our infrastructures and development capacity enhancement projects of the pharma industries and chemical industries. So I think my strength is to step in my foot in all type of challenges. I am work ethic, so whatever the job I have been allotted, I am always love to do that and go beyond that to complete the task. So I think this is my strength, which helped me to shift to one profile to other profile and the other profile. I'm ready to take any type of task. So I think this is my strength.
And when I ask, as you as a person, sir, actually, as a person, what are your strengths and what are your weaknesses, sir?
As a person, I have told you that I am work ethic, so this is I consider as my strength. But weakness, I couldn't able to give much time to family, maybe my personal weakness. But that doesn't mean I don't give time to family. I believe that we should give a time to family. Time which is, we have to give a specific critic time when they were required. So I am always with my family when they are required.
Sir, how do you define leadership, sir?
Well, leadership, I think, is a person who motivate our group of persons and team to boost their confidence, to encourage them to do new things, and ask them to come out from the fear of failure.
And how do you develop leadership qualities among your team members, sir?
I as a person, I encourage my team to bring new ideas, to develop their communication skills, encourage them to come with new ideas. I used to listen to them. I used to mentor them to develop the new ideas. Whatever I want, I ask them to correct if they are somewhere wrong. If they are going a wrong path, then I ask to them to correct in that path to go with proper directions.
Sir, do you believe motivation is important, and how do you motivate your team members, sir?
Yeah, definitely motivation is very important. Without motivation, I don't think people can perform or outperform their performances. Motivation is required to encourage them to come up. Motivation give them freedom to express their views. Without motivation, they will suppress their feelings and they will not come out. And I think when they will not come out, you will not get a better results.
Sir, how can we flourish innovation at unit level, sir?
I think to develop innovation, first you have to develop yourself to understand the things. You have to ask questions. What is right? What is best for me? What is best for my organization? And when you start understanding, getting the answers, if you don't get an answer, you ask somebody. There are a lot of things, online tutorials are available, magazines are available, like youth people gives a lot of information are available. Even manufacturers and good manufacturers, they come and sell. So they give more ideas, and then you can define their product to suit your requirement. So that's a very innovative we have to there, because we have to definitely in the today's world we have to be innovative. Innovative in terms of energy saving, energy conservations, in terms of reliability of the equipments, in terms of operation friendly. So it's a continuous journey of innovation is there.
Sir, because you're working at the post of general manager projects, and ZS Cadila is one of the best companies in India actually that we are having. So there would be a lot of stress that you would have undergone at some point of time. So how do you manage your stress, sir?
Yeah, stress sometimes, we have lots of projects, undergoing projects around there. In my flagship, I'm mostly doing 40 to 50 projects at a time. So definitely there are stresses at some level, but best way is to remove the stress. If you feel that the stress is there, you're not getting any idea, stop for a while, take a deep breath and think on other projects. And then once you get relaxed, then come back to that project. So you, with positive spirit, when you come back to the other project, you will definitely find a solution to that. And in that way, all projects will run simultaneously. So that's the way to relieve the stress. Secondly, to keep yourself fit is important. Physically fit, you are also mentally fit. Your stress levels goes down. So for that, I used to take brisk walk in the morning. Sometimes when I get a time, I used to meditate for some while, and that's the thing.
Sir, because you said that you're handling 40 to 50 projects at a time, so it's big job that you're doing, sir. So do you get enough time for your family, for your friends,
Yes, sure.
How do you manage your time, sir?
Yes, sure. With the proper time management tool, we used to do all the projects. Basically, we do the projects when we go out of the office. Definitely, we take some burdens with us. But I'd never give my burden to my family. I used to be socialized with them. I used to give a very responsible time to them, whatever they require. Responsible time is whatever the real time they require. I want to say that. Not like that I am sitting with them and looking at the TV and enjoying both and not talking with each other. Whenever we used to interact with my family, I used to give an interactive time to them. I understand their problem. I used to talk with them. We used to play good indoor games, sometimes outdoor games also. In night, if I go even at 7 or 8 o'clock, With my kids, I used to play badminton with them. So it's exercise for me, a stress reliever also, and they will also get enjoyment rather than seeing a TV. So that's the way we used to enjoy. And on weekends or some Sundays, I used to help my wife in my kitchen, in the kitchen, like that way, so I can have a interactive time with, while cooking also. I can prepare some different type of variety dishes to help her. So that's the way we can help and give time to my family.
Sir, parents play a very important role in our lives. Mm-hmm. We are Indians and we are Indian engineers. We are deeply rooted to our soil, our land and our culture. So irrespective of the fact that whether parents are literate or illiterate, their teachings and their upbringing actually plays an enormous role in shaping our life. And actually, the teachings, so can you share any one teaching of your father and one teaching of your mother, which crops up in your mind whenever you are under some sort of critical situation at that point of time, and then which gives you a ray of hope and which boosts you or which provides you enough energy to deal with that particular critical situation?
Yeah, actually, I lost my father in 2011. But I used to remember him. He was a very jolly type of person. He used to enjoy the life. He used to make the people. His face was always smiley face. He used to give laugh to others' face also. So I remember father that he is very much kind and involved in social activities and all this, giving back to society. His main motive was to give back to society, and think that he told me that society gives us, so we have to pay back to society. So whenever you get a time, do something for good for the society. You should be, whatever act you do, you should be conscious towards the society. So that's an important learning I always remembered of my father. And my mother was also very, she was a very strong woman, whatever the challenges she had faced in her life, but I think she had never gone, let her go with it. The thing of her attitude of never to get troubled or never to get tired and never to not to give up spirit, I would say. So that I think I have imbibed from my mother, never to give up anything.
And sir, please tell us, who is your favorite teacher and why?
Long back when I go to my schooling, we have one teacher, Mr. Daksap. He used to teach us history. And he was very good yoga teacher also. So first of all, the way he teaches, he was so master in teaching, that whatever he tell, we never has to go and home and back to revise, because the way he used to teach, it goes directly in our mind. So still, if somebody asks about history, what he had taught to me, I still remember the history. The way he teaches, taught us, na. So think. And secondly, he was being a yoga teacher. He has taught us to meditate and get relief from the stress also. So I think I remember Dr. Sir very much.
Sir, whom do you consider your role model or guru, sir?
Role model, actually, before joining Zydus Cadila. I was with Cadila Pharmaceuticals. In Cadila Pharmaceuticals, I was heading production department there. And at that time, there was a need to come with increase the production capacity, and they required a project department to set up. Being in production department, I have the knowledge of the production requirement and what type of new plant has to be made. So management asked me to work in the project department. Till they bring the complete setup of the project team, to start with the project activity, do some conceptualization, basic engineering, and start the project. Whatever you know about the subject very well, what is your requirement as a production guy, what type of capacity you require. On that note, I have started with that, and at that moment, one senior member, Mr. Indam Basu, has joined us as my boss. And under his guidance, I have learned a lot of things of projects. If I am handling project today successfully because of him, that the way the minute things of project activities, the project management and everything he had taught me, so I consider as a guru. And that why now I am from that time, last 15 years I am continuing with the projects. I am so much involved in projects that I love this, this job as a project person. So I think, I salute Mr. Arindam Basu, that being he was, no doubt he was being a civil engineer also, but he has in-depth knowledge of production process, industry process part also. And he has told me about a lot of civil, electrical, mechanical, all subject, all fields of, so I have learned a lot of from him. That's why I consider him my role model or guru.
Sir, can you share any one incident from your life which says that your parents are your God?
My parents were very broad-minded in sense. They were very broad-minded. They have never pushed me to the what they want for me to do. They have always given me freedom. Whatever I want to do in my life, whatever I want to achieve as a in my professional career, they have always supported me. So they have supported. I want to become a professional. I want to become an engineer. It was my choice, and they always supported me to become an engineer. In fact, whatever in my life, whatever I want to do, they have always supported me in that sense. And their wish was that they have always wished that I should flourish in my career, whatever I do.
Sir, would you like to thank your wife for her support and help?
Yeah, definitely. She plays a very vital role in my life, basically. She used to take care of me, a stubborn husband, taking care of her stubborn husband, my kids, my house, my parents. And she's always behind. Whenever I get stressed, she's become a stress soother for me.
Sir, how do you spend your holidays, sir?
Holidays means being in project department, we never get a long weekend, but whatever the weekend holidays or vacations or yearly vacations, I used to take my kids, my family to some natural places where they can love and enjoy the nature.
Sir, how can we save energy at plant level, sir?
Well, nowadays a lot of improvements has been done in the everywhere. Improvements are going on. Lot of improvements has been done in the energy efficient equipment, usage of LED bulbs, with variable frequency drives has been already in place now. Air conditioning with thermostats are there to control the temperatures. Now the star ratings are there, so we can save a lot of energy. Efficiencies has already been started. In project states also, we used to take care that how we can make any infrastructure with well ventilated light, natural ventilations and lighting systems. We have also gone for solar energies, renewable source of energy like solar and wind energies. Also, we are trying for that wind. We have already tried for solar energy, but we are also trying for wind source as a source of energy. So that way, we are cutting off energy. And like this campus, we have made Lushington campus where we are sitting. The campus is made like with the terrace gardens and everything to keep the temperature 1 or 2 degree lesser than the atmosphere. So in this way, we can save the power and energy here.
Sir, your concern about environment and pollution control, sir?
My responsibility increases when being a project person. My responsibility definitely increases a lot. To save from the carbon footprints, to prevent the losses to the environment. Whatever the projects I used to do, I used to make sure that minimum carbon footprint should be there in the plant. So by selection of best technology, available technology, we can reduce the things. Whatever the plants we used to design, right now which have a proper excretion policies, or we can call it the zero discharge facilities. So right now, whatever the new plants are coming with having a proper tools and techniques to monitor, analyze, and control the effluents.
Sir, how do you update your technical knowledge, sir?
Well, best ways to earlier we used to read upgrade ourselves by reading books. I am fond of reading books, but nowadays lot of online stuff is available. Even online tutorials are available which help you, which give the latest informations to you. And whenever I get time, I used to attend seminars, exhibitions, etc. I used to meet people, new manufacturers and suppliers, etc. They give it updated technologies. So that's the way I keep myself updated.
Sir, what kind of maintenance is carried out at your plant? Please share your maintenance plan.
As a maintenance, I think my maintenance person, he should be vigilant enough to understand. Smartly understand the machine. You should read the machines first. Every machine gives indications in terms of leakages, spillages, vibrations, unusual sound, etc. If a person able to understand that and catch that, then he can able to save the machine from major disaster or breakdowns. So this I think preventive maintenance is always important to keep all machines in the. If by preventive maintenance we can reduce consumables as well as machines will be more efficient then.
Sir, can you share some insights about the projects department, sir, actually? What are the basics of projects department, how it works, and what are the things that actually falls in projects department?
Basically, any organization, the project department is responsible for any type of any infrastructure development required need of the business. Infrastructure means not only buildings, but infrastructure built up means we have to cope up with all type of requirement, whether it is a regulatory market requirement, whether it is a compliance requirement, whether it is a safety requirements. Infrastructure, regulatory compliance. Being in the pharma industry, we are much more. We are for the regulated business market. So regulatory requirements, whatever the changes coming, that we have to update accordingly and changes the facility to that level, tune to that level. So all type of whatever the things required, it's come under project department to facilitate the manufacturing facility accordingly. So first thing is the conceptualization of that thing. Then second thesis is execution, and third part is the commissioning of the facility. So these are the primary official roles of a project department to do this successfully.
Sir, please name few machines or equipments which are heart of your factory.
For manufacturing in API, it's basically chemical bulk drug. For manufacturing of API, we require reaction vessels, which we call them reactors. Filtration equipment, which we call as either centrifuge, filter press, agitated Nusch filters are there. Then we require powder to be dried. For that we have various type of equipment, drying equipments are there, including steam tray dryer, vacuum tray dryers, fluidized bed dryers, Nota dryers, rotary vacuum dryers, pedal dryers are some of the, these are the main machines. Then we require lot of pumps to transfer fluids, and then crushing equipments like jet mills and all these are the important machines for API industries.
Sir, you purchase machinery or equipments directly from the manufacturers or traders, sir?
We purchase basically it is all machines are customized machine, tailor-made machines for the productions required based on our requirements. So we directly go with manufacturer, fabricator to make machines for us. But the standard machines are there, like pumps and all this we use to procure directly from suppliers.
Sir, what are your purchasing parameters, sir?
For purchasing parameter, important is the quality. Quality, we are very much quality concerns. Being a pharma industry, we have to be very much quality concerns. The design of the machine should be that there should not create contaminations in our product. So contamination and cross contamination are a very important factor for anything. Second thing is important for us is safety parameter. It should be well equipped with all safety parameters should be there. Third is the machine should be maintenance friendly. I'm not saying it should not come up maintenance, but it should be maintenance friendly, or should come up with minimum maintenance.
Sir, would you like to thank any local machinery or equipment manufacturing company which would have helped you during any of your critical situation?
There are lots of companies. We are working with lots of manufacturing vendors, so I don't want to pinpoint any one of them right now.
Sir, please name manufacturers or companies' names whose machinery or equipments that you are using in your plants.
As I told you, we are a lot of manufacturers whom we are going with, because specific machines we have to go with specific vendors. So lot of machines are there, and I think more than we are for manufacturer, we have more than 50 manufacturers from whom we are procuring machines.
Sir, kindly name one manufacturer which has been blacklisted by your company and reason for blacklisting. And we are asking this question because there are few, willful defaulters in the market actually, who have the habit of doing default in company A, and they go and do the same kind of default in company B also, which actually endangers the life of people who are working in plants or process plant, and which causes some small, medium or large accidents occasionally. So just now to educate about the rest of the process industry engineers about those companies, they can be educated about those companies so that they can take enough precautions while dealing with those companies.
Well, we are dealing, as I told you, we are dealing with a lot of manufacturers. We are happy that most of the vendors are very cooperative to us and they are very quality conscious, as they have supplied whatever them. But there may be same few instances where we got things happen like that way. But I don't want to, again, as I have told, I don't want to pinpoint out them things, this type of thing. And I don't believe in blacklisting things first of all. But there's rare cases where we have to do something, and then we have to, stringent action is a blacklisting. First of all, we never believe that we should blacklist anyone. We should get cooperation from all them, because things has to be clean and right way. But I would suggest that whatever the new manufacturers are coming, they should not. Just to have cost cut, they should not play compromise the quality of the things. And second important thing is that the after sales service is very important for any to have a long continuity business. After, they should give the relation, to maintain the relation, they should be always prompt in after sales services. So these are the two things, I criteria, I believe, for longer running of any business.
Sir, it was a pleasure talking with you. We know that you're a busy man, but still you gave us ample of time and shared insights about your personal and professional life. We are thankful to you, sir. Thank you so much.
My pleasure to be part of it.